Hi everyone, I'm Dennis, this is my partner Rin. We are going to present our project briefly, a meditative VR experience that uses mindful breathing and interactive fireflies to foster self-awareness and connection. So our agenda is we will be quickly going through our project in overview, then we will go through the prototype development, then we will present our research, the backgrounds, along with the user testing and data collection and analysis. We will end up with our reflections and our learnings and future directions. So the name briefly came from the words breathing and firefly, but it's also inspired by our hope to give an experience that is about a brief moment of introspection. So starting with the project interview, what is briefly? So as a high level summary, briefly is a 6 minutes meditative VR experience where the user is guided through a mindful breathing practice in an immersive environment filled with responsive fireflies in a galaxy-like environment. The user will be immersed in a space where the fireflies will be there and they will be reacting to their movements and presence. Our goal was, first of all, to create this VR experience, but also to really foster feelings of self-awareness, emotional connection, and belonging through this mindful breathing and interactive fireflies that we have integrated in the experience. Briefly aims to cultivate a deeper connection to oneself and some self-awareness and connection. So the impact is these first two things, self-awareness and self-connection, is the first initial things that we have assessed. We are briefly prototype, and the assessment has done through pre and post questionnaires and semi-structured interviews. And these over here is kind of like extended future goals where we would like to see that briefly fosters senses of belonging and outer connection and also intuitive play. As well as these are future goals, potentially briefly being as a therapeutic tool and aid, everyday practice that people integrate to their everyday lives, and also coming up with design guidelines throughout this project to see what VR elements and design have enhanced these feelings of self-connection and self-awareness. So going through quickly our target audience, mainly we are designing this for visitors as an art gallery, or people who would like to have this VR experience as an application. We can skim through these sections, but these are pretty much, we have created three personas to really see what design elements that they might need. And these insights have actually helped us to design the experience for multiple people with multiple needs. So we can just skim through that quickly. Okay. Our prototype development, we have embraced an agile development process. And what that meant is that we had a lot of technical limitations, which added to significant changes throughout our whole creation process. The first thing is we have no technical knowledge to an extent, so we had to get a no-code approach. For us, that meant using the Unity VFX particle system because that's a no-code approach, so we had to learn that. The second thing is we had to remove biofeedback, which initially got really excited about working on this. However, it seemed to be too complicated within the time constraints, so we pivoted to essentially doing mimicking and the breathing patterns through the fireflies and removing biofeedback. And then we kept the interactive pieces with the fireflies down to the very bare minimum and the essentials, because we still wanted to give that effect because that was a huge part of our core and the vision. So our process is we always focus on the vision and core mechanics. We would have weekly check-ins and we would discuss and prioritize features. We had lists of features and we would continually say, is this core? Is this, like, if we take this out, does the significance of the project go, or can we improve that later on? We had continuous iterations to balance everything to be able to create something that had emotional impact, but also was feasible to create in the time limits that we had. We also had to be very transparent with each other in communicating internal deadlines. We also had an external collaborator, so we had to adjust to their timing as well. So our inspirations, as you know, are fireflies. So we've gone through looking at the flock patterns and behaviors of how they interact in nature. Our aesthetics is following, so lots of purples and blues. We've gone through a lot of experience maps, but how agile and iterative we were being did not match up to the catch up to this process. So these are initial ideas where we got to think about the experience and sketching, really getting into the journey map. And then time flew by so fast that we had to just create it on the go. Different components of the Briefly project. This was not just about learning VR and creating VR. We had a custom sound design, we had the narration, and we had the physical installation, which all came together at the end. For the prototype, we're not gonna show the video for time purposes. We have a lot to go through, and you have already experienced the experience on Tuesday for a showcase, so we can just skip this. The core mechanics, though, we have integrated pass-through in the transition phases at the beginning. The narration and the soundscape was very core to the experience. The immersive VR environment with galaxy-like fireflies, as well as the reactivity and the head movement, and also the firefly flock mimicking the breath were our key components on this experience.
So for the research and background, we started with our theoretical frameworks that we were trying to acknowledge, specifically the transformative experience framework, which was discussed in class, really inspired us to kind of create a moment that would allow people to kind of either have an emotional or kind of cognitive change towards connection and awareness. We also used ethnographic interviewing as a framework to set up our semi-structured interviews. We used a phenomenological approach as well as the pre-setting and post-setting, which was aided by pass-through, which is why it was a core mechanic we involved within our project. And we also took a lot of inspiration from the article strategies for fostering a genuine feeling of connection, and took inspiration from that in order to create those genuine feelings of connection with VR. The previous literature that we found focused a lot on disconnection and loneliness, as disconnection was kind of the main problem we were trying to tackle. Disconnection from the self and others, as well as a lack of self-awareness, was associated with loneliness, depression, anxiety, emotional dysregulation, and other disorders and diseases. However, connection, awareness, and belonging are considered inherent to humans and deeply important for health and well-being, which is why we were trying to play off of these ideals and create these feelings of connection and awareness. Virtual reality has been shown to be used as a tool for creating mediated genuine connections with others, and it has also been shown to provide opportunities for social interactions and aid in creating these connections over long distances. Mindful breathing has also been shown to induce relaxed states and decrease these feelings of depression and anxiety, so our literature search was showing that maybe combining these might provide new opportunities for fostering these. As previous research in VR applications has shown that combining virtual reality and meditative breathing can further enhance connection. Despite all this literature that we found, there were still some gaps. Specifically, a lot of the breath interventions in VR that we found were focused on pain management or other sort of management instead of inducing these feelings. Connection and awareness were not often assessed in VR research as a dependent variable through the research, as well as intuitive play and meditative for meditation and relaxation is not a common thing seen in both VR research as well as the VR applications on gaming programs such as Steam or MetaVR. This leads to our problem statement, which was lack of connection and awareness of the self negatively impacts connection with others and the self and can lead to loneliness and mental health issues. So specifically the disconnection, lack of self-awareness, loneliness, and mental health issues that were brought up during our literature review. This led to our research questions of, can Briefly increase users' sense of self-awareness, belonging, and connection to themselves and others? In what ways can Briefly specifically experience self-connection? And what design elements most effectively support these connection, relaxation, and playfulness? As well, we have our ethical considerations, which we've gone through before in our previous presentations, but we wanted to include them as well here, essentially making sure that VR was safe and usable for all applicants and ensuring there was no previous issues anyone might have to make the VR experience uncomfortable or harmful to them. For our user testing and data collection, we recruited 18 participants through convenient sampling, including the SFU Project Showcase, word of mouth, and internet ads and sponsoring. For our participant demographics, we had 8 women, 9 men, and 1 person identifying as genderqueer or non-binary. We had a mean age of 28, but with a standard deviation of 6, and unfortunately, 1 participant was excluded from the final data analysis due to an incomplete survey. For the methods, our participants went through informed consent followed by the pre-experience survey, and then they were led to the VR experience area that we had set up in the black box, and then they did the 6-minute experience followed by the post-experience survey and then the ethnographic interview, which took between 8 and 12 minutes. For the interviews, we received a total of 12 participants, which was all of the participants on our second day of data collection and 4 participants from our initial day of data collection. For the pre- and post-experience survey, we included 5 different subsections in the pre-experience, and then 4 of those were repeated again in the post-experience. So this included the 5-facet mindfulness questionnaire, which assessed user mindfulness before and after. Then we created some connections assessing bodily connection and bodily awareness, and as well as the general belongingness scale, which assessed how users felt connected and belonging to others within their day-to-day lives, as well as the social connectedness scale, which assessed how people felt their social connections were strengths. And then in an additional analysis, we collected CESD, which was the Center for Epidemiological Studies Depression Scale, as a measure of depression. For all of these scales, higher scores were related to higher feelings of all scales. So some of the questions were reverse coded as they were negatively framed in the questionnaire, and then the scores were able to be added up for analysis.
For the ethnographic interviews, we just added a sample of questions. Initially, we had 9 questions, depending on what users said. It was semi-structured, so depending on what they shared, there was a little bit deep probing. But here's some example questions. Can you describe your overall experience with briefly? That was the starting question to get the interview started and to talk. Did you notice any changes in how you felt connected to your emotions during the stay? How was your experience interacting with the fireflies?
Our first data collection day was the showcase on November 26th, followed by a full day of data collection on November 28th.
And we have a quick video of one of our participants interacting with our experience.
Now we can move on to the data analysis and results. For the survey analysis, we used SPSS to analyze our data with a paired sample t-test. We set the alpha at 0.1 due to our small sample size and the low risk of potentially having a negative results should our results be proven significant, and then we errorously assume they are correct. This meant our confidence interval was about 90%, which is a little low for some research. However, due to the nature of the study being pilot, we didn't want to assume too much from our previous analysis. This included 5 separate analyses, including 1 for each subsection of the different surveys that we collected, as well as a combined section, since adding up all were positively additionally, meaning higher scores meant the same thing in all subsections. The data collected included the t-score, mean scores on the surveys, as well as standard deviation and the significance. For the results, we found significant differences between pre- and post-period post-experience scores in all our analysis except the SSC analysis, which was only analyzing the SCS before and after the experience. However, the FFMQ, researcher-created questions, GBS, and then our all scales combined showed significant differences before and after people completed the experience. So this meant there was significant changes in feelings of connection, feelings of belonging, and all of those feelings combined, including our researcher scale questions of awareness and bodily awareness.
So in terms of the interview analysis, 12 interviews was transcribed, and then 35 initial codes were found. That got down to 34, combined one of the 2 themes, and then 33 was used for the actual analysis because it was just 1 quotation, so maybe in the future we'll have more data to add onto that theme. Next slide, please. So all of these codes were written an insight summary, gathering what is the essential idea of that code, which then were themed and grouped into 9 themes overall, and then that was further grouped into 4 high-level themes to make the analysis easier. This analysis is still ongoing, so I will mention the very quick a few insights that we have gathered. Firstly, there was a very clear emotional impact with more than half of the interviewees describing how calm they felt and how this experience helped them and how they needed this reflective moment. It was a clear also impact on what the people took with them. So there seems to be a pattern of how people were affected by this beyond just this experience. The second is there was a very clear connection between interactivity levels and immersion, which is very exciting for us to see and improve on that end. And also along with like desired interactivity that was mentioned. The next is there was a very interesting duality between preference of stillness versus exploration. The next one is a lot of pathway for design iteration. So there's lots of things that we have identified that can be better for the next version, and also balancing the senses. All right, reflections and learning. So now that we're here and we have done all of this, this was our initial limitations that we have identified. And we are very proud that regarding these limitations, we have got to a place where we were able to showcase a project and collect data. Our advantages turned out to be very, I guess, like
essential,
and so a very dedicated and hardworking team. I think that really took the project to where it got to be, and also help from other people. This is our combined learning, so applying framework from the VR literature, being able to understand what other people have done and to see how we can integrate that into our research and learn from them. Writing a research proposal and paper, mostly for me. Virtual reality and VFX systems, like that whole technical, and lots of GitHub and all of that, all of the other essential things in the technical. Coordinating a data collection day, designing a mixed method study, still can't believe we did that, an agile development process, and academic and creative collaboration to create this project. Looking back,
our motivations, I honestly don't think have changed all too much. I think if anything, I feel more inspired than before to kind of keep moving forward and creating more. I know I came into this project with a lot more academic focus, and it feels nice to kind of reconnect with the creativity I felt a lot during high school and my undergrad. So I also was very excited because we got to do a lot of these things other than depression treatment, I would say. We kind of did a lot of these that I wanted to do.
And for me, reflecting back, I think for me, the other tip of the balance, like I came a lot from design and experience, and I think it was wonderful to see my first experiences in writing and talking about my research, seeing where it fits in academia and actually doing a study and conducting it was very crazy. So coming soon is Briefly Paper. So we want to take our final paper to Kai in January. So we would like to keep continuing on this and actually really reflect on the design iterations and integrate the design iterations into the next version, and hopefully we'll continue on these studies. There's also some EEG.
Yeah, so we're hoping that in future iterations as well, we can bring back some of stretch goals that we initially had to cut for this presentation, this project, including breath biofeedback, as well as including EEG to evaluate the biological relaxation and changes induced by Briefly, instead of just the behavioral and personal changes. We can see more of an objective measure of these changes. Sarah, any questions?